Hello guys, how's it going? My name is Dal, and with the patch 10.26 we saw a variety of new collectible rewards added with this newest update. And that's not including the new mounts, weapons, pets, and even outfits added with the Plunderstorm event. With the 10.26 we got a new Dragonflight Completionist achievement which awards the goodest boy Tyven, but also the previous expansion of Shadowlands Completionist achievement has also got a bit of an update. Initially, finishing out Shadowlands granted you a title which was unique but not nearly as exciting as a brand new mount. Well, with the patch 10.26, they have rectified that achievement by adding one of the most requested mounts into the game. The Shade Beast mount, which was normally a gladiator PvP only reward, has finally been added with its non-armored version for anyone that completes all of Shadowlands' major completionist achievements. So just like the other day we did a guide on how to unlock Tyven in the Dragonflight expansion, I wanted to do a guide for the Shadowlands completionists in order to earn yourself the most requested mount from the Shadowlands expansion. But right before that, most of you guys watching these kind of guide videos are still not subscribed. However, the more of you remind, the more of you do. So let's keep it going. Subscribe to the channel and ring the bell if you're watching these videos anyway. Especially if you want to get more regular content regarding Dragonflight 10.25 or any future updates for patches like 10.26 or the War Within Alpha. First, let's go over some of the raid and dungeon achievements required for the Shadowlands completionists. First of all, you'll need to defeat every single boss from the Castle Nathria, Sanctum of Domination, as well as the Sepulchre raids. In Oribos, you'll find Tay Elfar, which is a broker that allows you to experience all of these raids through the Elfar difficulty. By doing it on Elfar, a huge portion of these bosses can actually be soloed, however, not all of them. Certain bosses such as the Jailer do have specific mechanics that will make soloing these encounters a little bit more difficult. That's why personally I'd recommend for you to bring a party of at least 5 players to go with you in order to make a lot of these encounters much easier to get through. Best part about doing these Shadowlands raids is the fact that our max level 70 characters outscale this content. You will need a little bit of gear in order to be able to comfortably get the majority of these encounters, but a minimum of item level 437 or so should allow you to solo or at least bypass a huge portion of these in a small group. Besides raid achievements, we also have dungeon achievements with the Myths of the Shadowlands dungeons, which requires you to defeat all of Shadowlands dungeon bosses on Mythic difficulty, which is quite easy. However, this list does include the later added Tezavesh Mega Dungeon, which is going to be part of this achievement process. However, if you didn't play back in Shadowlands, you actually had to unlock the Tezavesh Dungeon at least once on one of your characters before your entire account got access to that instance. To start the quest chain, to unlock the Tezavesh instance, visit the inn in the main central Oribos area. The very last noteworthy dungeon achievement worth covering is Fake It Till You Make It, which is an achievement that you earn for defeating Tezavesh dungeon on hard mode. To unlock hard mode Tezavesh, you first need a clean instance of Tezavesh. I would recommend doing it on heroic. Once you're in a heroic version of Tezavesh, defeat the first boss so that you can access the rest of the entire market. Once you defeat the first boss, hang over to the right into one of the darker alleyways where there will be a questionable trader who sells you fraudulent credentials. Buy the credentials from the trader and then head over to the Oasis Club, and then you need to complete a trading minigame to unlock the entrance to the Oasis. Once you enter inside, hang left and talk to Ao Manal to exchange those credentials for a passably forged credentials. With this new necklace, you'll now have access to the hard mode version of the dungeon instance. To enable hardcore Tezavesh, you'll need to zone out of Tezavesh, set it to mythic, and then zone in into a fresh instance. Once inside, you'll need to equip that passably forged credentials and then use it in order to turn yourself into a broker. Once you get your disguise, you'll need to talk to Fei Tajin, a broker that'll help you access the hard mode version of the instance. Once you click through all of his dialogue options, you'll be able to enable the hard mode version of this dungeon. Afterwards, you should go through the entire dungeon instance and just blast through all of the bosses all the way to the very end to unlock this achievement. However, it is also highly recommended to do hard mode Tezavesh as a group, at least with one extra player. This is because for the final boss of the dungeon, it'll require 2 players to pass a beam through one another. And you'll need to pass this beam through relics which surround the boss that grant the boss 99% damage reduction. Technically, you could just solo the boss with this 99% damage reduction buff, but it will take you roughly about 10 minutes in order to do so on your own. But having a friend with you by your side will allow you to clear through the relics and remove this debuff completely, thus making the fight a lot easier to get through. Next, we have Renown and Covenant Campaign achievements, starting off with Dead Men Tell Some Tales, which requires you to complete every Covenant campaign, which is pretty easy to do. Go to Ouroboros, join a Covenant, and then go through the entire storyline of the Covenant until you finish it fully, and then you can switch over your Covenants back in Ouroboros. The next achievement is going to be Renowned, which is where you'll need to earn 80 Renown for every one of the Shadowlands Covenants, which does sound like a lot. However, there's already a lot of in-game systems in place since the end of Shadowlands, where you have a lot of catch-ups present, so you should be able to get through all the Renown for all the Covenants passively as you do all of the other in-game activities. The next achievement is going to be Sanctum Superior, which requires you to upgrade all of your Covenant's Sanctums with Rank 3 buildings and structures. These Sanctum upgrades provide you and your Covenant various bonuses, from additional mobility in the form of portals, to additional activities that are Covenant specific, as well as additional rares that you can now unlock within the regions of those Covenants. To upgrade parts of your Covenant's Sanctum, you require Redeemed Souls as well as Anima, which will earn through a variety of open world content. Anima is awarded through a variety of Shadowlands activities and is the easiest resource to replenish. After you replenish the Anima for a Sanctum, you'll have a questline that allows you to gain additional souls in order to put them to use in your Covenant's Sanctum. However, upgrading various parts of your Covenant Sanctum has a bit of downtime involved, as in there's actual in-game time that needs to pass before certain buildings or structures are eventually built. This means that you should go back to those Covenant Sanctums once in a while just to get some of the structures rolling and let them slowly get built over time while you work on other objectives and other achievements as part of the Shadowlands completionist goal. As you upgrade your Covenant's Sanctums, you also get access to your Covenant's special features, which is required for the Shadowlands Dilettante achievement. The event theory Covenant, for example, will be able to host lavish parties, inviting a variety of different guests to partake in all of the festivities. Necrolords will get access to a new crafting station where they can craft their own abominations. Nightfae will get to grow a garden of souls, and the Kyrian will be able to partake in a trial of loyalty. All of these activities have their own unique achievements involved with them also, which you will need to unlock separately for each and every one of the Covenants. This part of the Covenant achievement process is one of the more time-consuming ones, so make sure to pace yourself accordingly and just focus on one Covenant at a time until it is fully completed. Besides Covenants and Renown, we also have additional open-world achievements, some of which are going to be very straightforward, like the Chains of Domination and Secrets of the First Ones, where you have to complete the story chapters of patch 9.1 and 9.2. Then we have Walking in Mophis, which requires you to complete all of the unique achievements and encounters within the Zone of the Maw. While in the Maw, you can also complete On the Offensive, which requires you to participate in Covenant assaults and earn achievements within those assaults, which will be on a strict rotation, with different Covenants attacking different parts of the Maw, which will unlock you access to certain achievements at different times. Leaving the Maw, we also have the Zone of Xerath Mortis with an achievement from A to Xerath, which involves completing all of the Xerath Mortis' open world content, such as finding all of the unique treasures, doing the main story chapters, completing special encounters, and even crafting creatures in the Xerath Mortis Protoform Forge. To unlock the Protoform Forge, however, you'll first need to complete a few chapters of the Xerath Mortis storyline. During the story chapters, you'll unlock access to a console as well as a companion of Pokopok, and with the console, you'll be able to modify Pokopok even further. At this console, you need to unlock the Aelic Understanding, the Daelic Understanding, to unlock a quest that introduces you to the Protoform Synthesis. From there on, you'll need to unlock the Soprarian Understanding to then further unlock Mount Crafting at the Forge. Mount Crafting is going to be a little bit more involved. Each and every single mount has a very specific recipe that you first need to unlock before you can even craft that mount at the forge. Afterwards, you'll need to collect very specific items from some of the creatures in the Xerath Mortis in order to combine all of the different parts and reagents together to start crafting mounts for your character as part of the mount crafting achievement. Up next, we have some Torghast-specific achievements, starting off with Many, Many Things, which is an achievement that has you access as well as unlock the entirety of Box of Many Things. To obtain the Box of Many Things, you'll first need to run into a specific broker NPC on one of the floors within Torghast to pick up his quest. You turn the quest into Rune Carver, which allows you to start utilizing the box for your subsequent Torghast runs. The currency used to upgrade the box can also be collected from future Torghast runs, which feeds back into the box and allows you to passively complete more of Torghast achievements, as well as unlock further ranks of Torghast going forward. The next achievement is going to be Tower Ranger, which is a lengthy achievement that requires you to get through all of the base Torghast halls, completing them at layer 16 as a flawless run. Which means you'll need to go through those runs fairly quickly, slay majority of the foes on that floor while freeing as many souls as possible and taking as little damage as you can from any of the traps or in any of the elites. Another part of the Tower Range you'll need to complete is the Twisting Corridors Layer 8, which takes a little bit of time to work towards, as you'll need to start out at Layer 1 and work your way towards Layer 8. However, every floor and every layer should be generally easy for level 70 players with some decent endgame gear. Finally, you'll need to complete the Layer 4 of the Jailer's Gauntlet mode, which just like Twisting Corridors is something you'll need to work up towards, though it isn't as difficult or as lengthy as every other Torghast activity. Lastly, you'll need to meet the prerequisites to complete the Master of Torment achievement, which you'll likely end up accomplishing throughout some of your Torghast runs. But all in all, that's going to be the entire list of activities and achievements you need to accomplish if you want to earn yourself the Shadowlands Completionist. For some of you that played back in Shadowlands, this is going to be a little bit easier to get into since you don't need to unlock things like the Tazavesh dungeon or Torghast or any of the other in-game activities. Though for some of you that have been a little bit out of the loop or didn't even play Shadowlands whatsoever, I will have some additional guide information in the description of this video to hopefully help you get started. But this is going to be the entire guide on how to unlock your own Shade Beast mount for the expansion of Shadowlands. I want to thank you guys all so much for watching this video and I hope all of you enjoyed. Let me know all your thoughts in the comments down below. As per usual, if you guys enjoyed this video or found it informative, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. I would very much appreciate it. And as always, in the description of every single video and live stream, we have a link to our Discord community channel. Probably the best place to reach out to me directly in case you want to let me know what you thought about this video or hang out with the rest of the community to discuss some of the upcoming changes. Join our Discord to become part of the community. But otherwise, thank you all so much for watching this video. I do hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know all of your thoughts down below. And as always, I'll see all of you guys in another video.